Hello everyone, I am Dr. Abhishek Dave, Consultant, Cornea and Cataract Surgery at Center for Sight, New Delhi. In keratoconus, the front part of the eye, the cornea starts getting thin and it starts getting weak and it starts protruding out. So the shape of the cornea, instead of a smooth sphere, becomes irregular. And that is why the light is not able to focus clearly over the retina. And the person is able to see a hazy and unfocused image. What are the symptoms of keratoconus? So usually the disease starts at about 12 to 14 years of age. It might start later also. The person starts seeing blurred, and even with glasses, the vision is not very clear. There is a very frequent change in the power of the glasses, and the person develops a high cylindrical power. So once the patient comes to the doctor, certain tests are done, most important of which is something known as a corneal topography. So there is a scan of the cornea which is done to see whether there is some irregularity in the shape of cornea or not. If it's a very early grade keratoconus, nothing is to be done, only glasses are to be prescribed. And if with glasses the person is able to see clearly, only glasses are to be continued. And a repeat corneal topography is done after every 5 to 6 months. So if the corneal topography shows that there's a high-grade keratoconus, or if on serial corneal topographies we find that the keratoconus is progressing, in those situations we need to do the treatment, and the treatment is known as corneal collagen cross-linking, or C3R or CXL. It's a 30 to 40 minutes procedure in which a dye is instilled into the eye and ultraviolet rays are shown, with the help of which the cornea is cross-linked and made stronger. One thing to remember, this is not a vision enhancing laser or vision enhancing procedure. It's just to halt the progression of cornea and bring it to a stable level so that the vision doesn't deteriorate further. So that is something what we can do with the keratoconus as such. But next question arises, what do we do with the vision? Because mostly patients of keratoconus would not have a clear vision with glasses. So one option is something known as contact lenses. So not routine contact lenses, something known as rigid contact lenses or semi-soft contact lenses are used. So these lenses are first tried over the eye. If the person feels that the vision is very good with these lenses, the person goes home with the lenses and then can use the lenses regularly. But what if the vision is not clear even with contact lenses? Then there are certain other kind of surgeries which are known as intacs. Intacs is basically a corneal ring which is placed inside the cornea of the eye, and along with that a cross-linking is also done to regularize the cornea so that the vision quality increases with glasses. Second procedure is something known as Topographic Guided PRK. So in that, along with the C3R procedure, a limited laser is done to reshape the cornea of the eye. Remember, this is not something same as LASIK, but something similar to LASIK. There is no flap which is raised over the cornea, but a direct laser ablation is done to regularize the cornea along with the cross-linking, so that the quality of vision increases with glasses or with contact lenses. Third is something which is known as ICL. So ICL is basically an implantable contact lens which is placed inside the eye permanently. This kind of a procedure is helpful for only those patients who have very high power to begin with, and also who have good vision with glasses. So to sum up, keratoconus is an ailment of the eye which one should be concerned about, but do not panic, it's not a blinding condition. There are treatments available at all stages of the disease, and the cornea specialist will guide you best what treatment is best suitable for you.
Follow Center for Sight and post your queries to get answers from the experts.